Here are some exciting coming attractions from Paramount.
Mr. Driscoll, there seems to be some reservation about granting your parole.
You've never expressed any remorse for the crimes you committed before you were incarcerated here. How do you explain that?
How can I say I'm sorry if I don't remember what I did?
Stacy Keach.
I was hoping that you might be able to help me out.
Who donated this?
I spent the last 17 years in prison. My whole face was reconstructed.
It's a good face.
Geneviève Pujol.
You're really not going to go with him, are you? Did it ever occur to you last night while you were sitting by the fire looking into his big green eyes that this man isn't exactly a Boy Scout?
What happened?
Mr. Eric's boys don't seem to like me.
I have the money, and I have the power. There's no way. I'm gonna let you come back to life. Take it all.
A burning secret is about to be exposed. A secret worth dying for. Two strangers are caught in the middle, and it might cost them their lives. A man without a past, and a woman desperately searching for the truth.
If we go back there, maybe you'll remember something.
Maybe I'll remember what it feels like to beat a girl to death.
Hello, brother. That's the brother I remember. My brother's dead.
Harlan, we all thought you were dead.
Get out of here!
Identity. Starring Stacy Keach, Geneviève Pujol, Veronica Cartwright, and Mimi Maynard. And now we're pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
Yeah. Quayle is coming.
Take the Baron's case to the prior study.
Oh, very well,
Brother Theodore from Padua. Your last contribution allows him to work on his illuminated manuscript, the Stenbach's Quarrels, which will be the finest in the world. Where would we be without you, Baron? You, a man of culture, will be remembered for generations for his endless acts of generosity.
Don't be ridiculous.
Our best year. We have set aside 16 cases for your pleasure.
How extremely generous, Prior.
Your compliments are always like a two-edged sword, Baron. But nevertheless, I treasure them. Your estates in the valley continue to expand?
Yes. The Troost family were evicted this morning.
You know when your priest is coming?
Prior, I have little time for the comings and goings of priests.
Quite so, quite so. But we should be careful.
Why?
My dear Baron, I turn a blind eye to your property acquisitions. In return, you finance my monastery. We don't want a new priest sticking his nose too deeply into our special arrangements, do we?
I foresee no difficulties. How about some more wine?
Come on!
We're back from the war!
Magdalene!
Where's Magdalene?
Prior, Father Joseph Moore from Salzburg.
Ah, the Archbishop's protege. Please come in.
Thank you.
May God be with you, Prior.
And with thy spirit, Father Moore. As you know, or perhaps don't, I told the Archbishop that I considered you far too young for this position. However, it's my duty to carry out his orders. Is this your first parish, Father Moore?
Yes. I was the Archbishop's secretary for 2 years.
Is that so? Oberndorf is a quiet village, Father Moore. Traditional, set in its ways, free from revolutionary dogma. So if you have any ideas about changing the world, you better keep them to yourself. Until the vicarage is renovated, you will room with Mr. Gruber, the village teacher. And kindly attend to your hair and habits. You look as though you have been dragged through a hedge. Not the way a man of God should appear to his flock. Nor is Schiller's book, The Robbers, proper reading for novice priests. You would do better to concentrate on your Bible.
Your Reverence, I shall do everything in my power
gone in my office. And as far as my appearance is concerned, I'm not ashamed of my poverty. Didn't Jesus walk barefoot with his disciples and throw the money lenders and the rich merchants out of the temple?
Thank you for refreshing my memory.
And as far as Schiller, your reverence, I read his works because he speaks to my very soul. I think for myself. And it's not your responsibility to dictate my taste in books. Your reverence.
Heed my words well, Father Moore. That is all. You may go.
Cossacks. Make that 400 Cossacks.
400 Cossacks?
There were a lot of them. And we cut them down with our sabers.
You stupid liars.
No, it's true, Sophia. Our colonel personally commended us on our bravery. Didn't he, Hans?
Troopers Bader and Hans, he said, you are brave men. A fine example to your fellow soldiers. Your bravery will be...
Do carry on, Trooper. Don't let me interrupt you. Tell me, Trooper...
Bader!
What news of Lieutenant Conrad von Seidel?
Sir, we don't know. We didn't see him after the battle. He was badly wounded. We were separated during the attack.
Liar. Not only did you turn my oldest son against me, but you took him off to Russia and left him there to rot.
No! No, no, sir.
Conrad forgave you, Baron. He asked us to tell you that. You left him to die alone without the comfort of a priest. His death is on your conscience. And in his name, may you be damned for all eternity.
Excuse me. Do you know where Franz Gruber lives?
Over there.
Thank you.
Welcome, Father. My name is Robert. We've been waiting for you.
Nice to meet you.
Let's go in, please.
All right.
This way. Mr. Gruber, Father Moore is here.
Welcome to Oberndorf, Father Moore.
Thank you. It's very nice to be here.
This is my wife, Elizabeth.
Hello.
Welcome to our home.
Thank you.
Oh, and this is Robert, who helps us in the school.
Yes, we just met.
Oh, please, please, come in, come in. Make yourself comfortable. You play the guitar?
A little. Actually, I consider myself more of a poet.
Wonderful. Well, I write songs, and the children sing them at school.
I'll take care of the cold winter nights.
Your help.
Thank you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Sarah. Happy birthday
this
to
way.
You.
You two. Out!
Oh, come on, not now.
Thank you.
Search the place.
Captain, these poor fools have no money to pay for anything. It might be better if you raided the officers. Out!
Don't touch her.
Stop! Oh. Oh. He's killing all you're good for. Oh. I bet you wish you could be so wild and bad. Get up quickly.
Captain, there's nothing here.
Let's go.
You can rob us, you can rape us, you can kill us, but you won't have our soul. We will never die.
Why do you hate him so much? Because he's a hothead?
Because he's a free-thinking, Schiller-loving radical. In Vienna, liberal students are being thrown into jail, Father. I fully support the measures the Emperor and Metternich are taking against such trash. Might well be an enemy of the church. Had you thought of that?
Because he reads the robbers? Yes, yes, he's different. But he's a fine priest.
Nevertheless, I have to inform the Archbishop. He'll question more and make his own decision. Well, I wish you a speedy recovery, Father. And may God be with you.
We need clients to pay top prices for our liquor. We need heavy drinkers.
Good, Bader. With that kind of thinking, there's no way we can fail. Listen to me carefully. I've arranged a deal with the army commander of the border. He will buy everything we have. Delivery next full moon. But I feel it's going to be risky.
Yes, I know. The full moon. Werewolves.
Not werewolves, you idiot. Jansa and his bandits.
Then to hell with the captain.
Joseph, you realize the type of people here, don't you?
Hmm? What do you say, Gruber? Huh? They'll never come to church uninvited.
Come. Let's convert them.
Joseph, are you out of your mind? If the people in the village find out, they'll report it to the Archbishop in Salzburg. I want nothing to do with it.
What? Come. Not if we convert them first. Trust me.
Joseph, this is absurd. Look at them. Look at them.
Would you come here? Shall we? If you insist.
Leave, Joseph. We don't belong here.
Gruber, they're just trying to provoke us. Eat.
But I...
Smile. Be happy.
For you and your friend, Father. With best wishes from Hans. We don't see many priests around here. Tell us your name.
Father Joseph Moore. And yours?
Magdalena. Queen of the night.
Magdalena. That's a beautiful name. As beautiful and as special as its bearer.
Why, thank you, Father. Nobody ever said something that nice to me before. Thank you.
Prost, my friends.
Ask him what his God thinks of smugglers.
Hans wants to know what your God thinks of smugglers.
Smuggling is covered under the 11th commandment.
The 11th commandment?
Yes. Don't let thyself get caught in the act.
And now for some more music.
I think we should leave.
Bravo, maestro.
Don't go yet.
melodies are beautiful.
Thank you, Joseph.
Not only that, I think we picked up some converts.
Better wait till Sunday.
At least now they know that church isn't for just old women.
God is for everyone.
Yes, they feel you. God betrayed them. They grieve to forget war and hunger.
It's wonderful to be here.
You're very welcome. And you will find the people, good people here in Oberndorf.
I already have. Hans Gruber and his family have welcomed me to their home.
God bless you. And remember, I'm always here for you if you need anything.
Thank you, Father Nosler. Please, pray for me. Good day.
Thank you, Father.
The new priest was at our school today.
Really? What did he have to say for himself?
He said we should love one another and not hate. Something like that.
Sounds like another one trying to preach the impossible.
What's he like? Is he young and handsome?
Helga.
All priests are the same. Poor, miserable fanatics.
We'll take coffee in the other room.
Thank God that we finally have a priest who'll hear our confession.
What's wrong with the prior, Fräulein Anna?
Oh, he's too busy with his manuscripts and his singing monks and his
wine-making.
He's not for a simple person like me. We need someone who speaks our language, not Latin.
Everyone is welcome in church.
Good day, Mom.
It's nice to see you in church, Magdalena.
Yes, well, I forgot it's the anniversary of my mother's death today. She died many years ago. Didn't God tell you?
No. But I'm sure he received her into heaven.
Cruel and ruthless. How could he have caused an innocent woman so much suffering? Can you answer me that? Was he? Where
was ill. My mother was dying of starvation.
Come, Magdalena. Magdalena. The world isn't always what it appears to be. God loves us beyond our comprehension. And believe me when I tell you that all he wants is the best for us.
Come on now.
Not quite ready for you.
No? Where in Thebes crucified with Jesus Christ? I have robbed, burned, and plundered. I thought God loved sinners like me.
Normally he does. But in your case, he needs more time to prepare.
Don't be smart with me, priest. I own this place. Neither you nor your God will change that. They've taken too much away from me. My house, my family, my future. Where was your God when I needed protection?
No, priest. There's no God in this world. Believe me.
It's time for action. And not for hymns with kids and old women. I am for the revolution. And live for nothing else.
Let's go, brothers. We have work to do.
If God loved humanity, he wouldn't let all this happen.
Magdalena, it is man who destroys the life that God gives him.
Oh. Well, why doesn't God take better care of his gift? Why is he never there when you need him? Why doesn't he stop the suffering?
Virgin Mary, pray for me, guide me. Don't forsake me, Holy Virgin. Give me strength in my hour of need.
The Archbishop hasn't answered my letter.
Well, we must do something.
Do you have something in mind, Baron?
Yes. I will have Magdalena sign a statement saying that she is Moore's mistress.
That should discredit him.
He must go.
Our prayers will be answered, Baron.
I've lived and breathed for this moment with every beat of my heart. Waiting for you. Waiting. But you left it too long, Jansa. You rode away just once too often.
But I'm here now. And you will always be mine. We
with you by my side, I'll be strong enough to carry on the revolution. The struggle against oppression and freedom of thought.
What a dreamer you are, Jansa. A fine gentleman who believes he can lead his lawless bandits into victory by outdoing Metternich in the cohorts and the spreading of terror. No, Jansa. No, I won't go with you.
You have another man.
I can't. No, I don't.
Otherwise, you wouldn't talk to me like this. Who is he?
Bring me Magdalena.
Yes.
Good morning, Baron.
Yes?
I wish to talk with you.
Talk?
Not here.
Well, you have to wait.
I won't wait here. Meet me in the gatehouse.
What do you want?
I want you to sign this. Or you will do as I say.
My mother to take care of me when I was small. You raped me when I was 12 years old. Then you sold me to that prior to blackmail him into taking care of your dirty schemes.
Shut your mouth.
You call me a whore? To be a whore with any man out there is a life. To be in the hands of filth like you in the prior is worse than death.
Shut your mouth.
One day you'll be banished for this. You and the prior. And Father Mo will help me.
All is finished. You have been with him, haven't you?
He's a man, a real man. Something that you'll never be, never! Don't! Get!
Thank you.
Padre Satanás.
No!
Catalina.
Magdalene is wounded. I left her in the church.
Oh, that's good for you.
She's so young and pretty.
She mustn't die. Yes, Magdalene. Yes. I'm here. Magdalena, you'll be fine.
Pray to God she doesn't die.
I meant no harm. I come to you this time for confession.
Not here. In the church. In God's house.
Thank you.
God bless you, Father.
God bless you, my son.
God bless you, Father.
God be with you, Father.
Have you heard whom he's sheltering at Gruber's place? Shameful. Oh. Something like that in our village. Someone should report it to the Archbishop.
I'm sorry to hear about Father Nostrum. We are old, old friends. As to the other matter, these are serious charges.
Oh, very, very serious, Your Eminence.
But did not Jesus say, what you do unto my lowliest brother, you do also unto me?
Cavorting around in beer halls, sheltering dying whores, sharing even his room with her, Your Eminence.
Mary Magdalene was also a sinner. But do you have proof? As long as we have no positive proof that Moore has violated the rules of celibacy, there's nothing we can do. He's a hothead. That doesn't make him a renegade.
Moore's father was a deserter. He never married Moore's mother. The only witness to his baptism was the hangman of Salzburg.
Proof, Prior. That is what is needed.
I will provide it. Something must be done. Your Eminence.
Prior.
Eternity, amen. Forgive me, Prior, for I have sinned. I have lusted after the whore, Magdalena.
Is that all?
No. She goaded me. I almost killed her. I didn't know what I was doing. It's all the fault of that damn priest, Moore.
Attempted murder. Fornication of venal sins. Pray for God's forgiveness.
Because of a godless whore.
God decides who's lost and who isn't.
Absolve me from my sins.
What will you do now?
My sister has a laundry in Salzburg. I'm going to work with her. It'll mean a whole new life for me.
I'm very happy for you.
I don't know how to thank you. You've saved my life. But
no thanks are necessary.
Forget me. More?
How could I forget the lady who taught me how to dance? Never.
More, I'd like...
God bless you, Magdalena. You ready?
They say I brought shame to the village because I saved a whore. Jesus said, they shall revile and persecute you for my name's sake. I can't stand these self-righteous hypocrites, Lafonsidal. They bring so much pain to the world. But what can I do? What? The church doctrine weighs me down. Can't always shout the truth from the rooftops. It's not easy being a man of God. Thank you, dear friend. God bless you and keep you with us for a long time.
Hansi, what if I get scared? Think of the money you'll get. Does it help?
I'm not sure.
Help! Ten! Fire! Holy Virgin, if you really exist, get me out of this, please.
I'm looking for Magdalena. Where is she?
What do you want with her?
Oh, my master left her a small fortune. It would certainly be to her advantage if I could see her.
You are lying.
There is some money. For a decent burial.
Thank you. Magdalena is in Salzburg, at her sister's laundry in the Getreidegasse.
May God accept your man into his fold. So beautiful, Chancellor, isn't she? What a pity she left you for a priest.
What do you want?
Just a small favor.
I'm listening.
You help me get rid of Moore, and I help you with your revolution.
What do you mean?
Just tell the truth. Did not take more Magdalena away from you?
The
This is the first time in my life I've looked the devil in the face.
You'll never make a revolutionary, Janson. You are far too sentimental. Magdalena. Sign.
The prior. Go to hell.
You will go to hell. But first you go to prison, Maria. For thieving, for prostitution. Unless you confess that Moore was your lover. We have witnesses. Sign.
You don't frighten me anymore, Prior. It's over. You lied to me. You punished me for things I never did. I don't have the devil in me. I never had the devil in me. You are the devil. You!
So tell me.
What?
What have you been doing?
I help my sister. And I go to church. Living together in another world where people were happy. A world without hate. Where everybody was good and helped one another. And there was peace.
Yeah.
Why can't it be like that in our world?
Because people haven't truly learned to love one another, Magdalena. To give rather than take. I learned that.
You did?
And do you know who helped me? You.
Me?
You changed me. When you were hurt, I prayed to God with all my heart that you'd live. Nothing else mattered. And he listened to me.
I love you. So much.
I love you, Magdalena. But I'm a priest. Nothing could ever change that. I have to go.
Gunter! Give back the tobacco you stole!
Don't start with the fairy tales. Go to that pit.
Fire!
I never laughed enough. There was too much hate in my heart. And you can't change the world with hate. I learned that. But now it's too late. I wasn't strong enough. Magdalene, she's so beautiful. Much too
right, Joseph? You know you look pale. I have to talk to you. Well, it's about Christmas and the organ. Well, in short, the mice have eaten it.
The mice?
Yes, the mice. Well, it's not funny. You know, you're worse than the children. How can we have a Christmas without an organ?
Oh, Gruber. We will think of something. God will help.
I hope so.
The mice.
Dear Moore, Christmas is almost here, and I wish you the best on this holy occasion. I loved seeing you in Salzburg. It was God's will that we should meet. I think of you every day. I know you're a priest, but you're also a man, and I care for that man with all of my heart. Your loving Magdalena.
Lord, when I fall, write me again. And when I stumble in the darkness, cast your light on me. Teach me to love others the way that you love us. It would make me strong. So I'll never cast doubt on my calling. Please, Father.
Silent night, holy night. Joseph, it's beautiful.
Thank you. Rupert, do you remember the waltz you played at the tavern?
Yes, of course.
Do you think you can play it in straight time?
Yes.
Father Nussler, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Mm. Oh, look.
How are you?
Look.
We're gonna get you back on your feet before the new year. That's a promise.
I don't think so. I think that God is calling me to his side. But I do want to see one more Christmas. And then I shall die happy.
What's all this talk of dying? Gruber and I have written a wonderful Christmas hymn. Huh? And I want the children to sing it for you.
A hymn?
Yes.
For Christmas Mass in the language of the people? That sounds very, very modern. But I don't see why we shouldn't risk a break with tradition. Those little mice. It would have broken my heart to have them poisoned. Actually, everything is my fault.
No.
I'm very sleepy now. I think I shall sleep. God bless you more and all you love, and protect the simplicity of your heart. I love you more. I'm very proud of you.
Father, I want to confess.
In nomine Patri et Filii et Spiritus Sanctus.
Thank you. God bless you.
Kyrie eleison. Christi eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christi eleison.
But now, let us talk about more pleasant matters. I have been informed that you composed a song in our language about the Holy Night. It is supposed to be quite moving.
Yes. Actually, Gruber, the school teacher, he composed it. I just wrote the words. But the children, they sing it like angels.
Holy infant, so tender and mild.
goodbye.
Thank you. God bless you.
I'm coming with you.
No.
Yes.
No.
We have to say goodbye, Magdalena. I'm going to the guy. I lost God and myself. Have to find him again. Pray for me. I chose God. Don't make it any more difficult than it already is. Please. God bless you. And keep you always.
I love you more. I will always love you. I will always love you.